Here are this week's new and trending AI tools that you cannot afford to miss. Later in this video, we'll get into automatic AI coding. It's a big buzz at the moment, but you're probably wondering how I did the intro to this video. And, well, I'm excited to say that just the other day, Pika introduced 1.5 hyperrealistic video generation with dynamic Pika effects, they're calling them, and I can't wait to show you how to try this right now. You upload a video, you can choose to inflate it, melt it, explode it, squish it, and crush it, and let's not forget cakeify it as well. Here, I'm just uploading a picture of me, and I can choose what I want to do. I can inflate it, and you can see that Pika 1.5 is now working away. They are experiencing high demand, and you can upgrade, but what I like about Pika is they give you a chance to try this stuff even if you have a free account. While we're waiting for that generation, it's a good point to say if you're enjoying the content so far, do throw a like on this video and subscribe as I do these videos weekly. Now, I didn't want to wait too long for these generations, so I've actually subscribed to the standard plan just for 1 month for $10. I think that's a pretty good deal. Now, if you like, you can also go ahead and upload a logo to Pika and try Pika effects out. So here's our company logo, and again, just click Pika effect and choose what you want to do with it. You can inflate it, explode it, squish it, and I have to admit, cakeify it is the best effect in my opinion. Pretty cool stuff from Pika, I'm sure you'll agree. They're called Pika effects, and you can try them for free now using the link down below. OpenAI had Dev Day in San Francisco this week as well, and they introduced a bunch of new things, mainly on their API, so that's the back-end codey side of ChatGPT. One of the most popular ones was the realtime API, and this is going to be great for doing real-time phone calls. Take a look at this quick preview that Twilio published on their YouTube channel this week.
Hello?
Hey there, how can I help brighten your day today?
Can you tell me a joke about owls?
Of course. What do you call an owl who's a magician? Houdini.
So essentially, you'll be able to make and receive phone calls in real time using autonomous AI agents. The real-time API, and I don't have access to it yet, sadly, but hopefully soon. But that's not all. They announced a bunch of other stuff, including a cool prompt generator. This is not really new. Claude have had this for a while in their API. But if you go to the link that I'll post down below to test out the OpenAI API, you can actually click this nice little icon when you're in the chat playground, and you can describe what you'd like to use the model for, and they will generate the system instructions. So for instance, I'm making an app that can respond to YouTube comments, and maybe I might type something like respond to YouTube comments. That's not a very good enhanced prompt. And within a matter of moments, I've got system instructions that are much more comprehensive than my single few words in a sentence. Respond to YouTube comments in a professional and engaging manner. It even gives steps: read the comment, assess the tone, craft response, how to deal with positive, negative, and neutral comments, and how to conclude. This is really cool stuff. We can try it again with something else. Let's generate a pimped up prompt that can write a script for my podcast from the notes. Okay, and it's going through and thinking about it, and it's done it. Create a detailed, engaging podcast script by expanding on the given notes. And it gives steps again: review, outline, expand, engage, add transitions, conclude, output format, examples. Oh, this is absolutely brilliant. Look at this, and you can actually alter this prompt if you want for your own use case. But it's easy if you've got kind of a block on how to prompt AI. This is going to solve that for you with ease, I think. Sam Altman put out a great post on X summarizing all of the new announcements at OpenAI Dev Day this week, and I'll link that along with the OpenAI Playground down in the notes below. Finally, let's take a look at automatic AI coding. It's a big trend this week and this month, and if you watch my previous videos, you'll see that I've been using AI tools to build an app with no code. Well, Replit Agent takes it to a new level. This is a service I signed up to do a little bit of app development, but they have an agent here, and you've got to see how cool this is. With one prompt, you can build something instantly. Now, you need to be on the paid plan, so you'll see I've paid for Core. It's about $10 a month. And I can paste in my prompt, which is about building an app. This time, I want to put in a YouTube video ID. It'll get the comments from the video, combine them together, use OpenAI and prompt to summarize all those comments and come up with 3 bullet points that can give ideas for future videos. Let's see how Replit Agent gets on building this all automatically right now. So first of all, the AI agent sets up a development environment for me, YouTube comment summarizer, and it's actually analyzing and doing a chain of thought right now to build out the app in front of me. I've got my first response from the agent. It says I've created a plan for the web app. It's going to summarize videos using different APIs. It tells me what it's using to make the app. And do I want to build the initial prototype? Yes, I could add extra features, but let's just get that prototype out, approve plan, and start. And away the agent goes to work right now. Look at this. It's writing all the code for my app right here in front of your very eyes and creating all the files over here on the left-hand side. And what's really cool is not only is it writing the code, but when it's finished writing code, it's going to install everything I need to make this app run. So I don't need to worry about missing dependencies or installing Python or Node. What is that on my system? It does it all for me. Look at this. Now it's installing the OpenAI module. Now it's installing things like Flask, and that will get the back end going. Now it's installing the Google API client. And boom, look at that. It's got as far as asking me for an OpenAI API key and a YouTube API key. These are really easy for me to obtain from both OpenAI and YouTube themselves, and I'll paste them into the values box. Now it's going to go on further and think and produce everything for me to run the app. Now you'll notice here as it does its chain of thought, it's detecting potential issues and thinking about them. So any kind of bugs it's introducing along the way, it is troubleshooting them for me. So I really do sit back. I feel like I need a cup of tea or coffee because the Replit agent is doing everything for me. And look at this. This is incredible. It's restarting my server. It's running everything. I don't need to touch the keyboard. So it's actually got something up and running for me. It says, is the server running and accessible? Can you see the main page with the YouTube comments summarize the title? And the answer is, yes, I can. Yes. Fab! Exclamation mark. And that's the most feedback I've had to give so far to the agent. Okay, so it's asking me, now the app is up and running, could you please test its functionality, try entering a YouTube video ID, the bit after the V equals in the URL, into the field, and click the summarize comments button. So let's go ahead and try this. I'm going to use one of my own videos, and this video was quite popular this week, so let's copy the link to that video and paste it in. And as asked, it wants me to strip out the rest of the URL. Now, if I was making this for production, I could include error handling to do things like that automatically. There is my YouTube video ID. Let's test this out. My goodness me. That is a one-shot app, and there is the summary. That has blown my mind. A YouTube comment summarizer. And well, obviously I've edited this video for my weekly update, but it took probably about 3 or 4 minutes to make that MVP app. So let's read this. Viewers praised the video for being high quality, fast paced and on point, but some found it too complex. Interest in tools and workflow. Many wanted to know the workflow used and about texts like Flutter, Replit and the cost of the tech stack. And the presenter received compliments on their tutorial style and voice. This is indeed a summary of the comments because I've been reading the comments on the video this week and it's done so elegantly. And that is a one shot prompt from Replit. It's an insane tool. You definitely need to try it. I'll link it up down below, of course. And if you enjoy what you've seen so far, do throw a like and subscribe because I'll be doing more videos like this to show you the coolest new AI tools to help you with content creation and creating anything really, coding automatically, just like this. Okay, one final bit of feedback to finalize the app. I've said it's brilliant, works so well. When the summary comes, it includes markdown symbols. Please change to use formatting instead and put a dark mode button on the app. That'll just make it easier on my eyes. Okay, now we're cooking. Now we're cooking with gas. Let's try this again one more time. This time I'm going to pull something from my other channel where I compare a couple of plugins. Let's copy the link to that Waves versus Isotope video just to see what my audience are saying. Paste in the URL, strip out the front, and let's see if we can summarize comments for this video. Boom, look at that. And no formatting now. This all looks very nice. Mixed opinions on noise reduction tools. Viewers criticize the lack of hands-on demonstrations and they're concerned about promotional tone in the video's outro as well. So immediately I can get feedback on this on how I can improve videos in the future, what people are looking for. This is an excellent tool. So when you finish creating an app and you want to launch it, you could even integrate a payment system to charge for your app. You then click deploy up here. And what this will allow you to do is deploy this in Replit's cloud and make it publicly available so people can type in a web address and access your web app. There has never been a better time now to make interesting and useful products that are helpful to people and even potentially make money by charging for access to the app. Go and try it out for yourself. Okay, I'm feeling on a roll, so I'm going to try and create another app, and this time a little more complex. Build an app that starts by asking for the user's email, stores it in a database so I can lead capture. Once that's entered, ask for an audio file to upload, takes the audio, adds light compression, hard limiting to -3 dB. This is techie audio stuff, my background. And then loudness normalize it to -16 lufs, which is actually the standard that you should be trying to meet when you upload a podcast. So if you're a podcaster, essentially I'm trying to create a SaaS app like Orphonic in one shot with the Replit agent. Let's start building and see what happens. Wow, okay, and it's building. It seems to know what it's doing. It knows all the Python libraries that are required to do clever things with audio. Right in front of my very eyes, the audio processor is being created. Okay, it tells me it completed successfully, so I'm going to try it. Okay, I entered my email. It tells me the email was submitted successfully. Now, I can check this by looking at my database over here, and you can see, yes, there is a user table that the AI agent created, and if I go into it, yeah, I've got an email address captured in my database. That's pretty insane that not only can it make apps, but it can integrate back-end databases as well. Back in the web view, we need to upload a file and click process audio. So let's try this out. Hello there, it's me, Mike, and I'm talking really loud and then quietly, and I'm hoping that my new app can process this audio. There is a waveform that I'm going to save now. Here we are back in my audio processing app where I can choose the file ai.wave and process the audio. Let's see what happens here. Whoa, okay, audio processed successfully. Click the link to download. No way. And it's download processed AI. That is insane. Okay, this is my audio editor with the original recording. I'm going to drag and drop in my new processed AI recording. And wow, look at that. Okay, it looks like it has been processed. Yes, indeed, it has been limited. I can see there. The big golden question, though, is, well, it's definitely compressed my voice. Look at that. Compared to the original recording, I'm now clearly much louder and easier to hear. Great for a podcast. But if I drag and drop this into the match loudness box, look at that. It's exactly -16 lufs. The AI app that I created in probably about 30 seconds can do stuff that a paid app like Orphonic can do, which just completely blows my mind. Replit Agent. It's like AGI for building apps and processes. What are you going to build with this? This is an insane technology. Go and try it in the link down below. And if you really enjoyed the video, do throw a like and subscribe, because I will be doing more stuff like this. I do weekly updates on my channel. I'm really grateful for you to be here. You could also help out by subscribing to my AI newsletter. Again, the link is down below in the description. And there's probably a video showing that, no, there definitely is a video showing on your screen now that you can go and watch next if you're really into all this automatic AI coding stuff. With that said, have a great week and enjoy playing.